Hi everyone, and welcome back to The Prime Ingredient. I have my friends Patty and Felicia coming to visit me today. They're from Basket to Blanket, and they have set up the most lovely picnic for fall outside. I am making a pressed picnic sandwich, a root vegetable salad, and a delicious, super easy dessert featuring today's prime ingredient, Genway tea. So we're gonna start first with the pressed picnic sandwich, and we're gonna just take this ciabatta that I bought. It's actually an Asiago cheese ciabatta, and we're gonna take a little bit of the inside crumbles out, okay? It just allows for you to stack it with some really good ingredients, and it also absorbs the dressing, which we're gonna put on our pressed picnic sandwich. And I love this sandwich so much because you can make it the day before and you go ahead and just keep it all wrapped up in the refrigerator. And it's super, super easy to do. So see, just a little bit. And I'm saving this because these make really great breadcrumbs, or if you want to do a little bit of crouton. So we'll save those for later. Actually, let me get a little bit off the side here too. So the first thing you want to do is get all your ingredients together. And those ingredients include our meats, which are really delicious crispy bacon, uncured applewood smoke. And I have finocchiolo, which is a fennel salami. And it's so, so delicious. Super mild, but it's really great for those fall flavors. The fennel is wonderful. Arugula is my lettuce, and I would really recommend you use a lettuce that is real sturdy if you're going to make this and let it sit overnight, because arugula will be just perfect overnight. You can also use spinach, but stay away from like the baby greens or the butter lettuces. Romaine might get a little sloggy too, but arugula is really good and it has that little bite in there. And then here are some of my vegetables that I'm going to be using. Tomatoes and cucumbers. We're going to slice up a little bit of a yellow pepper, some marinated artichokes. It's just going to be absolutely delicious. But the first thing I want to do is put on some whole grain Dijon mustard. You can also use my favorite Maille Dijon mustard. You might recall from my prime rib recipe for the holidays. And I'm going to use my basic salad dressing. It's the one that I use all the time. And this recipe you can find on my website. I used it during our premiere for season 2 as well. It's using my prime spice in there. Actually, let me get a spoon. And we're gonna spoon it on the thickest part of the bread. Now that's gonna be based on how you cut it, okay? So the thickest part of the bread for me is the top. For you, it might be the bottom. Just weigh that when you slice your bread. And get a really good hearty bread. Brioche is not the best for this. You want something that's pretty dense, so I kind of like a ciabatta. French bread is okay, but more of the Italian breads would be better. And you can just see here, I'm putting a decent amount of salad dressing on, and this gives, again, the flavor from, you know, the aromas of fall that are in my salad dressing, but it also gives a really good moistness to this pressed picnic sandwich. So what's in the salad dressing is a combination of 2 vinegars and a lemon juice, my prime spice, olive oil, and salt. And again, that recipe is on the website. Go find that. And now we're gonna add just a little smear of Dijon mustard. This happens to be the one with the whole grains in there, whole mustard seeds in there. So just use a little bit. You don't want a heavy smear of this, just a light smear, just to give a little bit of a tang in your sandwich. And make sure you get the edges. One of my most favorite parts are the edges. I take that after my mom when it comes to that, because that's where all the good stuff usually is. And although it can be in the middle, but you know, I do like the ends. Okay, now what you want to do is start layering your flavors. So we're going to start first with the Actually, let's do the salami first. And I'm just gonna make a little bed of that right here at the bottom. And this is kind of like an homage to the charcuterie, right? But we're putting it in a sandwich. And then we're going to add the bacon. And the bacon, which I've already cooked, is cooled also. You don't want to put super hot bacon right on top of the salami, or you're gonna get one big blech, big fatty blech. Not good. So then the bacon, let me see, I think I'll do a couple like right here. And you shouldn't need a ton. Maybe six slices should do this. And this picnic sandwich could feed 3 to 4 people because it's that that decadent. It's really quite good. And just for the heck of it, why don't I put another little layer of that salami right on top of the bacon? Can never have too much finocchiolo, one of my favorite salamis. Super, super good. Okay. Good. And now we're going to put all the veggies. And then you can decide what your veggie favorites are, but I do love a good cucumber. This is a hot house. And then a layer of Roma tomatoes. Don't be afraid to pack on as many vegetables as you like. I'm going to be using fresh bell peppers, but you can use roasted. And I'm going to layer them right on top of my tomato. You get enough, but not too much. You don't want it too peppery. Oh, look at that. Isn't that gorgeous? It's like a rainbow. It's beautiful. And then we're going to add our marinated artichoke hearts. Look at that. Isn't that beautiful? Oh, and then we're going to do a little shaved Parmesan just on top. Not much. I don't want too heavy of a cheesy flavor here. Really more focusing on the vegetables and the bacon and that salami. But just a little bit. Nice little nutty Parmesan. Get the one that you grate on your own. Go for it. Make a good prime ingredient out of that Parmesan. And then we have a little bit of arugula, and you can see it's kind of getting a good height here. Nothing is better than a nice tall sandwich, right? And then right before we close the lid, we're gonna take my prime ingredient, my original Mediterranean spice blend, and we're just gonna put a little bit on top of where we put the salad dressing, right there on top. Okay, just for a little extra brightness. And then we just very gently put the top on and give it a press. And now you can see why we took some of the bread from inside of the loaf here. And so look at that, isn't that gorgeous? So what I'm going to do is wrap this up in saran wrap, and I'm going to leave it in the refrigerator. And then for our picnic, we are going to unwrap it, slice it up, and just devour it. It's so delicious. Okay, so next is our root vegetable salad. So let's do that next. My favorite root vegetable ever, beets. I just absolutely love them. And I really enjoy roasting them on at my house. So sometimes we get beets in my garden. Sometimes I have to buy them from the grocery store. But I love to roast them at home, and it's super simple. It really is just throw these beets without the beet tops on there in some aluminum foil, put it on a little sheet pan, and let it roast at 320 degrees for about 2 hours, and just let them sit until they're cool enough to touch, put them in the refrigerator, and then the next day you can just peel them. And then I'm going to just chop these up, and then whatever's left over. I have already peeled and made into little carrot sticks and blanched these carrots. So I'm going to add, we want that kind of crisp tender. We don't want, a crunch here. We want it to mimic the texture of the beets, but not too soggy. So I kind of take them out when they're very, very al dente. And then I put them in an ice bath and let them come to, that kind of bendy state, but they're not mushy, okay? That's what makes a great, great cooked carrot. Let's do maybe a third of that last beat. Okay, we'll put that inside here. And now this is super, super simple. What a great, great salad this is, and easy. So you have the flavors, and it's so pretty too. So you have your carrots, you have your beets, and we're going to use some aged balsamic vinegar. Now, if you don't have aged balsamic vinegar, you can reduce it over a low heat, a regular balsamic vinegar, for about, you know, 5 minutes, just to get it a little syrupy, or you can use a balsamic glaze. But aged balsamic vinegar is really good, and if you can find a nice aged one, they are going to be pricey, but you don't just use it like a normal balsamic vinegar. You use it for things like this, a real special salad, and you just need a little bit. You can see how thick that is. Look at, oh my goodness, so good. So we're going to just put a little bit around there. And very special balsamic vinegar. I love this one. And we're going to put some olive oil. Get your favorite olive oil. This is a Palestinian olive oil. I do love the olive oils from the Middle East. Some of my favorites from Lebanon, Palestine. And then I'm using my original Mediterranean spice. And I'm going to give it a toss, and then I'm going to finish with a little bit of fleur de sel. Isn't that lovely? Now I'm tossing these together first because I don't want to bruise the arugula. And the arugula is going to go in right now with a little bit of that fleur de sel. And not a ton of arugula, really. Your main focus here are your root vegetables, the beets and the carrots. And you just want the arugula there pretty much for color, a little bit of flavor, and the fleur de sel just to brighten everything up. But look at that, isn't that gorgeous? Perfect for fall. This is a great, super simple recipe. And it just takes a little bit of advanced prep in the roasting of your beets, in the blanching of your carrots. But once you get it all together, you're done. Really pretty salad, okay? So this is going to go in the refrigerator. So for our fall picnic, I decided to make a super simple dessert. And all I did was chop up apples and pear and cranberry. I put them in a pot with about 3/4 cup of bourbon, cinnamon and nutmeg, and I let it all steep together with Genway tea. And this is rooibos vanilla. And it's, oh my gosh, it's so good. Oh my God, bourbon vanilla rooibos, so good. And I just put this in the pot with the apples and let it kind of steam all together, and then you get this beautiful compote. What could be better for the fall than a beautiful drizzle of caramel? And I'm just using Torani. Just a little bit of caramel. And then I'm putting what I like to call a little puff pastry cookies. It's super simple. It's just puff pastry. I used a biscuit cutter. I put those puff pastry on a sheet pan, baked them at 320 degrees for 20 minutes. And there I have a delicious dessert for our picnic. So next I'm gonna go get dressed into my fall flowy dress, and I'm gonna head outside in my backyard where my friends Patty and Felicia are there from Basket to Blanket, and they're going to have a beautiful, gorgeous display for our outdoor picnic. So you have to see this. You have got to see this.
Hello, I am Patty.
I am Felicia, and together we are the creators of Basket to Blanket. We bring you an exciting and new way of celebrating an outdoor picnic experience to you.
What we set up today in Dr. P's backyard is our rustic tea setup. We are using our table for six, which was custom made by our friends at Happa Joe Furniture. We wanted to bring the outdoors to the table and also create a modern, organic feel to this picnic. We decided in curating this table decor to be a combination of rustic and modern elements.
At Basket to Blanket, we can do a picnic setup with a beautiful charcuterie board and delicious desserts. But what Dr. P did was create this beautiful pressed picnic sandwich with a root vegetable salad and, of course, a delicious Genway tea steeped fruit compote.
We are really excited to bring this venture to Southern California in the Orange, San Diego, and Los Angeles counties. Reach out to us. You can find us on Instagram at Basket to Blanket.
Patty and Felicia, thank you for bringing Basket to Blanket to my backyard. It was just a spectacular day. And whether iced or hot or in a recipe with apples, Genway tea, always spectacular. Like and subscribe here on YouTube and join me on Instagram at The Prime Ingredient. One ingredient can make a difference. See you again soon.